Hey survivors, welcome to vlog 11. It's been a few months since the last vlog and we've got a lot of things to go over, including lots of work that's been done to develop as well as optimize our main world map. Just after vlog 10, we brought on 3 additional level designers to help assist with putting our world together. They've been a huge help on the project and lots of work has been getting done, with the focus of not only expanding our world, but also optimizing it and making sure that everything is functional in time for the closed alpha. We've still got a lot of left work on our plates, but we're excited to show what's been worked on since the last vlog. Canmore has been getting lots of love from the level design team and is nearly completed, with all of the bells and whistles that you'd expect from Dead Matter: doors, light switches, claimable structures, and much more. Canmore admittedly became a lot larger than we had initially planned for, but we're making the most out of it and using the town as a performance benchmark for the closed alpha. The town features a large amount of residential buildings, as well as some shops and even some industrial buildings near the outskirts of town. There's a large variety of locations to be explored within the town of Canmore itself. Key locations include a large grocery store, a library, an under-construction rec center, multiple Nera camps, the medical clinic, the police station, as well as dozens of residential and commercial buildings that extend all the way towards the police station as seen in vlog 10. Canmore is very large, and this cannot be understated. Moving on to some of the weapon and animation changes, Kyle has performed a pass on the vaulting system as a whole. It feels a lot more responsive than before. He's also increased the fluidity of the system overall, as well as improving the math that's being used to position the player. Based on feedback from our backer community, we've made a large push to include more civilian weapons in Dead Matter. While platforms geared for military use, such as the AR-15 and Kalashnikov, have a place in the game, we feel it is very important to have a large variety of civilian weaponry, since that's what you'll most likely be encountering while playing the game. To address this, we've added 2 new shotguns. The first one is an over and under shotgun. While it's technically not a new addition, there's a brand new set of animations and a brand new mesh with a set of different skins and attachments. So yes, you will be able to use a saw and cut down the barrel length to transform the weapon into a close quarters double barrel boomstick of destruction. We've also added a personal favorite of mine, the 1887. It's a lever-action shotgun that allows you to terminate zombies with machine-like efficiency. The 1887 and the over and under bring the total shotgun count up to 4. We're also planning on implementing a lever-action rifle in the near future. The M14 now has a complete set of animations. Both 10-round and 20-round mags are fully animated. Utilizing .308 ammunition, this gun is set to tear apart anything unfortunate enough to be on the other end of the barrel. Oh, and you can also set the fire mode to full auto if you find the right variant and you can handle the recoil. The Mosin Nagant has been revamped with a set of new animations that look 10 times better than before. The Shiny Haxorus has done an excellent job on polishing up all of the existing animations in the game in preparation for our closed alpha. We've also added a Canadian classic, the VZ-58. Originally designed and manufactured in Brno, Czechoslovakia, now the Czech Republic, the VZ-58 may look like a Kalashnikov, but that's the only similarity between the two weapons. You can reload the weapon via changing out the magazine, or you can utilize a stripper clip if you've got one available. You'll also be able to reload the weapon by inserting individual rounds. Last but not least, we've added 2 new pistols into the game. One of them is classic, not only for Dead Matter, but for the zombie genre as a whole: the revolver. It's a perfect addition that fits right into the cowboy culture of Alberta. We've also got the Tech 9, a rare weapon that's classed as a pistol. It uses large 32-round magazines, but it's easy to chew through the ammo with this thing. Make sure you're stocked up and plan accordingly. I've done a large pass on the inventory system, including restoration of some functionality that was removed when the inventory was refactored earlier this year. Carrying two-handed objects now functions as it did before, but with a lot more going under the hood to improve overall functionality and make it easier to implement new carryable objects. Large items that need to be carried in the player's hands have received a brand new set of animations instead of being attached to the camera with a head bob doing most of the work. On top of being able to precisely place large items in the world, you can also drop them in a pinch by simply clicking. You can also use large items held in your hands to fend off zombies by shoving them back. Any item with a sub-inventory can be placed in the world, including backpacks and container items. Based on community feedback, you'll be able to create a stash by placing a bucket while holding R, provided that you've got a shovel on hand. our old vehicle cargo system from Vlog 5 with predetermined locations for held items has been removed. We've now got a 3D inventory system that accepts any item that is capable of being placed from the inventory or two-handed objects that are carried in the player's hand. You'll also be able to access the inventory of any container placed into a 3D inventory. We're hoping that this will help with item management and hopefully make it a bit more streamlined when it comes to moving cargo around between vehicles. I've also implemented a modular crafting system that allows for a variety of item combinations. As an example, you can combine nails, a hammer, and a baseball bat in order to hammer nails into the baseball bat, granting a damage boost. Any sort of weapon modification that's reasonable on the fly, such as attaching or detaching rail-mounted attachments, will be used by this system moving forward. Gun has been working on a variety of different systems. Lockpicking has been abstracted into a minigame subsystem that powers the new hotwiring minigame, along with some help from Adam in the mesh and material department. We're super excited to see players try and hotwire vehicles, as when you end up making a mistake, the game will punish you by triggering the vehicle's alarm that will attract infected towards your location. Gun has also been working on a tree chopping system. All you need is an axe and a little bit of time to cut down a tree. Please note that picking up logs in the future will be similar to picking up a jerry can as shown before. I've implemented a brand new medical system that's tied into a brand new stat system that I've written. Any stat on the player can be modified with our user interface automatically accommodating for everything. This will allow us to very easily tweak the behavior of medical conditions, healing items, perks, attributes, and much more. Limb health is now much more important to look after. If your head or torso get knocked to zero health, then you will die instantly. Limb health restoration is based on your character's stats as well as your blood. If you're low on blood, your limbs will recover much more slowly. We've also got a few new animations that go alongside the use of the system, such as taking a drink from a soda can or bandaging your wounds. Just keep in mind, there's no immediate way to restore your health in the middle of combat, and it's best to choose your fights wisely. Our gore system has seen an initial implementation, however, we still need to tweak a few details and add some polish in order to really make it pop. We're excited to show the fully implemented gore system and damage system for the zombies once it's ready. There's been a pass on the vehicle system that's still underway as of right now. We've made sure to clean up the third-person animations for when you're inside of a vehicle or when you're observing someone who is driving a vehicle. Kyle has implemented a free look system that allows you to quickly observe your surroundings without changing your movement direction. The zombie AI has been improved. The animations are still a work in progress, but the zombie behavior is now much more reliable and scalable than before. Kyle has implemented a more robust AI spawn handling system that allows us to make sure you're constantly on your toes when firing weapons. Make sure you find a melee weapon and use it to avoid luring infected or even players to your position. If you are in our community Discord, you may have noticed that the developers either have the status of developing Dead Matter or playing Dead Matter. This is because of our Discord rich presence integration. We want playing with friends to be as seamless as possible and felt that a Discord integration should help make it easier, especially for when it comes time for the closed alpha. Players also now have nameplates and can group up together. The UI elements for this are still a work in progress and will be tweaked to minimize the amount of HUD elements shown on the screen. We will also be tweaking the behavior of the crosshair. Lastly, Nomad has replaced the main menu in-game, and we're quite happy with it. For those of you that have been asking, we've added the ability to play the game in single-player mode in time for the closed alpha. Please note that when playing the game in single-player, your computer will be under a lot more stress than playing on a dedicated server. If you want to get into the closed alpha or help support the project, you can still become a backer via Indiegogo or QI Software. We've added additional payment processing options to our own site, including PayPal. We're a crowdfunded project, so every contribution helps us out and helps you get cool goodies for being an early adopter. That's a wrap for Vlog 11. As we approach June, we'll be keeping in touch with the community and we'll be letting you guys know the exact start date for the closed alpha as soon as it's available. Everyone at QI Software is extremely grateful for the support of each and every one of our backers. We're all extremely grateful to each and every one of you that have helped make this project possible. We truly mean it from the bottom of our hearts. Thanks again for all of the support, guys.
We should probably split, because there's a...
What?
three or four more over
this
there.
This guy's not with us. Who the fuck are you? Give us your fucking pants.
Oh,
you know the fucking routine. Drop the fucking pants.
No, not again. Come on.
Take off the fucking pants, man.
Take off the fucking pants.
Oh, fuck.
I
fuck, shorty.